The second cutting of the beer bottle is a result of the problems they had from the first one. The first video, when they analyzed the cutter, it beat the crap. And it was all rounded, so it wasn't sharp at all. So I reground the cutter, and we're cutting this beer bottle again with a new sharp cutter. So it makes all the difference in the world. And it's really cutting quite a bit deeper than that last time. That's just a matter of adjusting the offset between the digitizer and the cutter, and the depth sitting in the NC file that we're cutting. But this is going quite well. It's really quite deep too. So, and you'll see in a little bit later, it picks up and plunges, and I actually broke the cutter. So what I found out is I'm going too fast. After I replaced the cutter, I slowed it down quite a bit, and the rest of the file is cut at a slower speed, which seemed to work better. So here we're going. I'm going to go down here, and then it doesn't show up, but I broke the cutter. We're going to stop right now.
That sounds good. That looks deep, doesn't it?
It's the trouble when you do this, you don't know what you're doing.
That is pretty deep. I'm afraid to do it with a full bottle, dude.
I mean, you got a little more pressure, and if it does break, it's gonna mess.
You have to have a grip pan and all that good stuff.
Yeah. Or you pray, whatever, I don't know. The cutter's cutting good.
Yeah.
I did something right there. I mean, the difference between cutting deep and not too deep is 5,000 maybe.
Yeah, it ain't very much.
No, it ain't very much.
The thickness of that piece of paper.
Well. It's not much. Well, it sounded like Glenn and Nathan went out to buy another tractor.
I'm going to draw the cutters in the house for a little bit.
If they don't go too high in the auction. Just what he needs, another tractor. Right?
Yep.
Remember, it's going to be on the internet. You don't want to say anything nasty. I might edit that out. Now I figure it's hauling ass. It's going. Somewhere around 40,000 RPM. I'm not sure exactly. I changed the
No, because the first time I had this thing inverted, I come down and this is sitting on here. Not good. So I flipped it over and put this insert back in there to drop it down. Hit that thing at the bridge. I mean, deep's good, I guess, as long as it don't break.
I did this first one I for you. I did the clip on.
You want to put a new cutter in every bottle. Oh, damn, I gotta put that. A glass like that, it's not good. I saw a guy on the internet. He was making circles, cutting circles in glass.
Yeah.
5/16 inch thick glass.
Yeah.
And scribe them. And he'd go around with a hammer, just tap it. And the crack would probably go around. And he'd do that. Around it, and then he flipped over and do the other side, and then the pop out. I mean, you see the damage thing, and you see it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this would be one of the damage things.
So it made you come up with the two out.
This guy named Robert Mann has a jewelry store in Golden. Wyoming, I think. Or Idaho. Might be Idaho. Anyway, somebody I did work for. One of his customers is in the... I think he's in the Army. He's in, I think, in Afghanistan.
Mm-hmm.
And he has a girlfriend, and he wanted a draft on a ring for his girlfriend. So they sent me a design, and I did something, and they didn't like it. So they sent me another design. This is a design I put on the side of the ring.
Oh, for them. Cool.
So. Keep going for the bottle to break. Looks good. I'm going to leave it both slow. It's working. If it's working, don't break it.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, I put two giraffes on it, on a tapered...
$75
for gold test. Anyway, as far as I know, it worked out okay. They use these touch probes to reverse engineer things, you know, copy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you have like a coin and you want to copy it, then you can digitize it. If you have a reactor machine, and then you can import that into CAD program and put it through the system, tailor it and edit it and modify it. Surface like this. And they use them for a touch probe where you can set the depth of the tool by coming over touching. I could do on this one here.
Mm-hmm.
This one here.
Right.
Except for it's not working right. I thought I had it working, but I think it changes now. No. So it's something I have to work on. But when it does work, it's great.
Yeah.
When I cut in those titanium rings, I'd use a limit switch to digitize the surfaces. Whenever you put a ring in a three-dot cut and put pressure on it, it's no more. You can't get it concentric.
Right.
You're just putting the pressure in it, it warps it. So I'd go around the surface of the ring, and digitize surface, and then create that surface in the MC file and project it on there. And it worked pretty good, because I was making really tiny cuts from that. Titanium's worse than glass. It's a bear to cut. With these small cutters, it's just hard. So I'd constantly change the cutters, and the limit switch to reset the cutter height worked well. And when it dialed in right and set right, it was beautiful. So, I just have to get the software working right. Grab his clutch piece here. So a couple of variables are the grid size when you digitize this. The first one I did was 2 millimeters between points, and this one is 1 millimeter. So finer grid size shouldn't give me a little more accurate surface, but it takes longer to digitize.
Right.
And then if the cutter goes dull, and it just doesn't want to cut. You can force it down and force it to work.
Why force it?
Well, it's just not predictable. And it'll be interesting to see how this cutter looks after we're done cutting. And if you know it's going to be shot after each pass, it needs to be tasted. So it's kind of hard to set to depth when, if it's not cut right, it doesn't, you know, plunge right, you know?
Yeah.
It's like when I tip that off, it's just sort of,
I'm just
guessing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking that you hold the thing down with the, just flat, horizontal, and touch it with a tight angle. The idea that it's going to touch the spot with the cutting edge. I grind them, try them. Some work well, some don't. It's not a real jet thing. But the good thing is, you just keep grinding until there's nothing left. That's my next video.
Yeah.
I want to do the cutter grind. I call it plunging.
Expensive.
I'm going to wait for next year. I'll wait for the gold, price of gold to come down before I try that. I don't want to procrastinate too much. Damn, it looks like it's working. All I want to do is get one of these that's good. Then I finish up the video and I'll be done with it.
Mm-hmm.
And then go on to real world stuff. You know, you make a video like this, you can do it 10 times to get it right, and you just don't want to make it look easy. So what are you doing today?
Goofing off.
Goofing off? I do that all the time.
Mm-hmm. I got stuff off that I did this morning from booking for elevator. And the way that he told me is he put his love to put it back together.
Mm-hmm. I think that load,
the more you're doing, it'll be good.
Yeah, it looks like it.
Yeah.
I'm going to cut this thing down now. There's some number lines in this spiral. That's the line that's not. This is how much space is left from what I cut it to cut.
Hit the home key.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Trust me. Go the right way. Here it looks.
You should take it out. Blow it out of your hand.
Yeah, that'd be good. It looks great. I think this is the best one yet. Boy, it's deep though. Yeah, I think it looks good. All right, we're done with this for now.